Welcome to the Best Coast Shire Council Report, your weekly update on council news and events.
Hi, I'm Steve Fury.
And I'm Lauren Grills.
And welcome to this week's show, where we'll be talking about upcoming small business festival events, a reminder about events for the Victorian Seniors Festival. But first, we're very happy to announce that the successful tenderer has been selected for Council's waste services.
That's right, Steve. We're pleased to announce that Council awarded contracts for the Shire's waste collection service and waste facility management, and also the operation services, in the closed session of the July ordinary meeting in Cowes last week.
Current service provider and local Bass Coast business Wonthaggi Recyclers was awarded the contract for waste services, which includes curbside collection, litter bins and hard waste collection, and also operations of council's transfer stations at Wonthaggi and Inverloch.
Ace Environmental was awarded the contract for the operations of council's Grantville landfill and transfer station. Both contracts have a combined value of approximately $6.6 million per year for a 10-year period. The decision was made in a closed session of council due to confidentiality around contractual matters.
Now, the start of the new contract in September 2017 will introduce two new services, the first being a resale shop at the Wonthaggi transfer station, and the second is the introduction of a three-bin service. The new three-bin system is made up of a 240-litre weekly kitchen, food and garden organics collection, a 240-litre fortnightly recycling collection, and a 120-litre fortnightly garbage collection. The additional cost to ratepayers of $51 means that the service will be less than $1 a week for each household.
The organics bin is not just a bin for your green waste. The bin will also accept garden prunings and lawn clippings like a normal green waste bin, but it will also accept any kitchen organic material. A key phrase for remembering what can go into the organics bin is, if it lived, it can go in the organics bin. Steve, can you give us some examples of what you can put in the organics bin?
Sure can, Lauren. You can put in fruit and vegetable scraps, meat scraps and bones, fish and seafood, including the shells, dairy products, tea bags and coffee grounds, tissues and paper towels, hair, pet manures and kitty litter, lawn clippings, garden prunings, that includes weeds and rose trimmings as well as twigs and branches under 100 millimetres in diameter.
Wow, Steve, that's quite a lot of waste that I'd usually put into my garbage bin.
It sure is. The introduction of organics and green waste bin will reduce Council's annual EPA landfill levy costs by over $127,000, so it's quite a saving. And it'll also reduce greenhouse gas emissions by over 2,600 tonnes of CO2 every year. Landfill space will also be reduced by around 5,400 cubic metres, and over 4,000 tonnes of organic waste will also be removed from curbside garbage every year.
Don't worry if you didn't catch all that. We'll be educating residents and ratepayers about the changes in the months leading up to the start of the three-bin system in September next year. Bass Coast will be the first council in Gippsland to introduce an organics bin, but it has been introduced in 9 other councils around Victoria, including Albury City Council, the City of Wangaratta and Greater Hume Shire. If you're a fan of the ABC's Grew and Transfer like I am, then listen closely because the next one is for you.
That's right, Lauren. As part of the 2016 Gippsland Small Business Festival, Dan Gregory, a regular Gruen panellist, is coming to Bass Coast. He'll be the keynote speaker at a business breakfast to be held at the Ramada Resort on Phillip Island, and we'll be discussing what makes us buy and buy in.
Even if you're not a Gruen Transfer fan, but you're a business owner, then this event is a great opportunity to network with other local businesses and a chance to be inspired by an award-winning speaker and renowned business leader.
The business breakfast will be held on Wednesday the 24th of August, starting at 7 a.m. Tickets are $25 and guests must RSVP at dangregorybasscoast.eventbrite.com.au by Wednesday the 17th of August.
With the Small Business Festival running throughout the month of August, there are plenty of free or low-cost events happening around Gippsland and in Bass Coast. Small business mentoring sessions and a visit from the Small Business Bus and the 2016 Bass Coast Business Awards presentation dinner will all be held locally in August. You can view all events and book at business.vic.gov.au/Gippsland Festival.
Just a reminder before we go for the Victorian Seniors Festival. If you're holding an event that is eligible to be listed in the Bass Coast Local Program of Events for this year's festival, then your registration forms must be in by Monday the 1st of August. If you need more information or a copy of the forms, contact Kylie Pryor on 5671 2404.
Thanks, Steve, and that's all we've got time for this week. As always, if you have any questions or need more information about anything we've mentioned, give us a call on 1300 B-Coast. That's 1300 226 278 or 03 5671 221. You can also keep up to date on facebook.com/Bass Coast Shire or follow us on Twitter at Bass Coast, and we're now also on Instagram at Bass Coast Shire. Catch you next week for more council news.
The Bass Coast Shire Council Report is broadcast on Tuesday mornings at 9:30, Thursday afternoons at 4:30 and on Saturday mornings at 10 on your community station 3MFM. Audio and transcript is also available from our website, vascoast.vic.gov.au.